Welcome to Fragnetic Fashion. My name is Marcus, and today I'm gonna discuss with you guys my fragrance review on a release by Navitus Parfums. And this fragrance is called Imperial. Now this release is one of three releases, brand new ones that just came out recently. So there was Away, there was Emblaze, and there's Imperium. And today, guys, we're gonna focus on Imperium. I will be doing reviews on the other ones when I have the chance, but for today, everything's gonna be focused around Imperium. The creative director behind all the Navitus Parfums is no other than Steven from the YouTube channel called Redolescence. And he's also created the first seven releases in this line. And now with these three brand new releases, he's up to 10 of them that he creatively directed. So man, kudos and congrats to you, man. That's amazing, fantastic stuff. And your fragrances are very luxury feeling, and price value proposition, in my opinion, is always solid. And I do own the other seven ones, the first seven, and I'll review those with time when I get to them, guys. I just need time because I have so many to review for you and share my opinions. But like I said, for the moment, we're gonna focus on these three brand new releases, starting with Imperium. And when you buy these, guys, you'll come with this type of a box presentation. It's like this nice sleeve cover. It looks like this all around. It does feel very luxury and niche, guys. It's absolutely fantastic. Very, very nice. And the box, they all look like this. They kind of remind me a bit of, you know, something like a Roja Dove, kind of like a box. Very nice, guys, very nice. I do enjoy the feel. It's like this very nice textured cardboard. It's very beautiful, and it does look and feel niche. So when you open the box, the bottle is there, and it also comes with the details on the fragrance. So as you can see, we have Steven from Redolescence, his name on top with Imperium. And in the back of the card, you have all the details on the fragrance notes. Now I'm gonna read you guys what the fragrance notes are, just in case that you're having trouble to see them. So in the top, we have Brazilian orange and plum accord. In the mid, we have chocolate scones accord, Venezuelan tonka bean, and suede accord. And in the base, we have Java vetiver, we have birch tar, and we also have guaiac wood. Now the perfumers behind this is Francis Kirkjohn, the new in-house perfumer for Christian Dior, as well as Jerome Di Marino. I know that they've made other fragrances in the Navitus line, and I don't own them or smell those ones, but hopefully I will be able to do so one day. But without further ado, guys, this is, like I said, brand new 2021 release, and I'm gonna give you guys the details of the smell. Off the initial spray, what I get is this intense, juicy, and dark plum. Then I get oranges, but it's not an orange citrus. It's an orange peel smell. So kind of like smelling a fresh orange peel. And you also get some sweet tonka bean and this chocolate ice cream milkshake kind of a smell. So here it's fruity, sweet, it's gourmand. In the mid, you get that suede textured leather smell with animalic tonka bean and that chocolate ice cream milkshake sweetness. So it's this rugged, sweet, gourmand scent. And at times, this might remind you of Uomo Signature by Salvatore Ferragamo, but it's just faint, guys. It's not identical. It'll just give you some remembrances of. And in the base, you get this woody, leathery guaiac wood. with a drop of vetiver and the vanilla tonka bean in that powdery chocolate ice cream milkshake vibe. So it's woody, sweet, and gourmand. Now for the performance, longevity, sillage, and all that regarding this fragrance. Off my skin, guys, I was able to get over an arm's length projection for 3 hours. Then the scent slowly came closer to the skin. To me, this was a skin scent at the 7-8 hour mark. And I was able to detect this off my skin up to 20 hours. Crazy stuff, guys. And for me, the scent on this is a solid 9 out of 10. I very much enjoy this, guys. This is gonna be a gourmand scent. And this is pretty much highlighting the notes of that vanilla tonka bean and that chocolate scones accord, the cacao scones accord. So this is what's making this so gourmand. And guys, to be honest, this is so easy to summarize. Just think of a half and half or twist chocolate vanilla ice cream or a milkshake. And to me, this is more like of a milkshake to me. So think about a vanilla chocolate ice cream milkshake. This is exactly what this smells like, guys. So if that interests you, at least sample this and take a smell to see if you enjoy it and to see if the performance is just as good off of you. But this is the simplest way to give a resume of this fragrance, and it's absolutely gorgeous, guys. For the compliments, I didn't get many compliments, but the people that usually love the gourmand scents, when they smelt this off me, they did enjoy it. They did find it very tasty and delicious. I even had a lady tell me that she would want to eat this. And yeah, guys, it's gonna be for the gourmand lovers out there for sure. Now for the wearings for this, I see this honestly anytime, any reason, any occasion, because it's not an intensely overly sweet gourmand. It's just such a well-balanced gourmand scent that it can actually work for all seasons and any moments. And it can be worn casually, just as upscale. It just has that, you know, jack of all trades characteristic and vibe to it when you smell it. So you'll never be out of place with this one. I think the only time I would not wear this is like at the gym, because I think you can still wear this in the office. You can still wear this going out. You can still wear this on dates. You can wear this in the cinema, whatever, guys, groceries, anytime. It's just that in the gym, I just don't think that this would suit that occasion, but that's it, guys. So it's actually one of these rare, versatile gourmand scents. And now for the price. What's good about Navitus Parfums is that they've changed the prices. They changed the presentation, and Steven mentioned it on his channel that he was looking into making it more affordable for us customers and for the fans out there of the Navitus line or that want to support Steven like I have. And yeah, guys, I do think that this is a good bang for your buck, 100%. And if you're a little bit patient, there's sales once in a while with them. So just look out for those sales, and this is going to be an even better bang for your buck, hands down. I don't think you can go wrong with this, guys, to be honest, especially with the sale. Now, this is my fragrance review on Imperium by Navitus Parfums. So, guys, this fragrance is not nuclear and it's not beast. However, it has some long-lasting power. And like I said, if you're not into that overly intensely sweet scent, this isn't it, guys. It's just so well balanced with all those other notes. And just think of that half and half chocolate vanilla twist ice cream, or just like I said, that vanilla chocolate ice cream milkshake of the frag game. And this is it, guys, in Imperium. Now I want to thank you guys very much for watching my review. I'll see you guys in the next one. And hopefully this information that I provided for you was able to enlighten and help you out. Take care, peace, and lights out.